Welcome back to Let's Play Cyberpunk 2077 Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're headed towards a very high, undiscovered thing. So I could track the job, but it has me go around like that, and I don't want to take that way, so I'm going to go this way and just head from the vehicle. There might be another vehicle we can... Is this... You don't see a lot of these 6th Street cars. I guess I could have taken that, but oh. Alright, here we go. Oh, there are some cars up there. That guy looked like he was an enemy. I understand fully. Well, not really. Okay, we crashed. I don't know. When we drive in vehicles lately, seem to be crashing. This is the century. This is the century. This is the century. Let's hope it doesn't happen this time, otherwise. If you crash again, I'm just gonna go on foot. Whoops! Whoops! We. I think the car is a little easier to control than this thing. Okay, there's the car for sale. Now we'll hit it from here. Well, it wants to go past it and then... Is that walking? Drive here and then walk over? We have to go up there, maybe. Oh, sorry. I was a little distracted. Hey, Regina?
V, the long time. The scrap broke out at a construction site. Dude responsible is heavily ironed. He'd be a great candidate for psycho study if you end this thing with him alive. Sending you the details.
I don't want to leave him alive. Cyberpsycho sign discount doc. I was pressing Z. What the hell is going on over there? One of the workers went psycho, started smashing up the construction site. Seems some of the workers tried to stop him, but their little poly one-shots couldn't pierce that exoskeleton of his. Anyway, they either ran or got added to the construction, if you catch my drift. Go check it out for me. Oh, it's there. Is that what all that noise is? Guys, all right?
Could always be worse.
Okay. Oh, brother. And this is the very high thing? Oh, it says moderate. Oh! That's not even that. I thought it was in a different spot. I'm like, what the hell are these over there, actually? Is that who it's supposed to be? Holden McCoy? How much fight you got left in you? Are you full or are you almost dead? Oh wait, that wasn't the enemy, was it? Or was it? Oh my god! You're on fire, dude. Take it, take it. Take another one. Oh, I can't have you interfering, sorry. I know I shot you before. Oh, crap! Run! Keep running! Why can't I run? Am I hurt? This is not a good place to be. I'm gonna be... Oh! Oh wow. That's it for me. It said moderate. The other one was high. I'm gonna have to run out of there. I don't want to stay in there. I have no control, okay. So, is this guy gonna still fight me, or will he join my side? I'm not sure I can get this, leave this guy alive. Crap. Whoa! No way! Alright. As soon as he gets out, like, well, not get out, but as soon as he finishes that other guy, I'm running out to the street. You know, maybe I should get some... Maybe I should jump up there. So he can't, you know... Still at 100. Oh, you're shooting me though? The guy's laughing. Oh, good God. I need to get on top of somewhere. Run. Well, if he won't leave, he's just gonna stand there. That makes it a lot easier, actually. All I have to do is not run out of ammo. All those criticals, good God. Alright, now let's see if this is a very stupid thing to do. How do I... This is a very damaging baseball bat. Is he still alive? I guess he's alive because I'm looting him. Well, or defeated, either one. New shard doesn't look good. I gotta say, that Mary of yours still sure has a head on her shoulders. She got you here at the last possible moment. Your body is rejecting the implants, and no wonder. It's not ready for them. They're military grade. You can't use them without the proper training. Christ, they're not for civilian use at all. I can give you a script for painkillers, but don't forget, the pain is your body's way of warning you. If you ignore it and keep using that chrome, you could cause permanent damage to your spine. You might be able to take off that exoskeleton now, but if you break your spine, you'll never move on your own again. I wonder if he did break his spine. Search the area to collect information. Alright, I'm still in combat, but I was able to save. Well, combat music anyway. Am I supposed to scan this? Oh, okay, I thought it was one of those things. Okay. Luckily, I saved right after that. I'm switching back, just in case. Yeah, I wish you could hit that and get to any weapon. What was I using? Shiguri, I guess? Corpse. Likely an employee here, shot with a heavy projectile. I don't trust you at all. Chase Coley. Likely a merc, shot with a heavy projectile. Anything else? Another merc, shot with heavy projectile. I don't want to fight him again. Kind of done with that. There's more information. I wish the music would stop like that. Cheap suit appears to be a corpo, shot with a heavy projectile. Quit your crying. From Tom Selvick to Chase Coley. Let me be plain, you've been in this biz long enough to know it's a rough way to make a living. This job should toughen you up, but instead you keep coming to me looking for a shoulder to sob on. Now, most companies just swap out their workers when they get tired, but not me. Here I tried to show you some compassion. I even rounded up some gear for all of you at a decent price. But what do I get in return? Ungrateful lunks like you. Just think about yourselves. Your own comfort. Company be damned. But it's thanks to me you got decent implants and a low-rate loan to cover them. And I did it for you, out of the kindness of my heart, so you didn't have to waste your time going from bank to bank, filling out forms you can't even read. But do I get so much as a thank you? Never. And you know, if it weren't for Mary and Charlie, I would have kicked you out on your butt a long time ago. So try thinking about them for once and get back to work instead of crying to me. This is construction, for crying out loud. There's no place for sissies and crybabies. But hey, if you think otherwise, you can go ahead and pack your stuff up. And don't dare show your face here again. I mean, show it once a month when you come back to pay your installments. Plus extra to cover that employee discount you won't be enjoying no more. Cut the bull crap. From Tom Selvig to Anelia Pays. I already told you, I don't give a crap about no warnings or restrictions or special terms of use. I think we both know you're not about to give me a warranty on this crap, so don't make me pay out my ass for nothing. Save the scop and let's do biz. Don't matter if they're salvaged from old military bases or fished out of some back alley's dumpster. Hell, could dig them out of an Indian burial ground for all I care, as long as they work. Hydraulics should be able to handle 2 metric tons, nothing else matters. My people will buy whatever I sell them, so just get your people to give me what I ordered. Pop, your head will explode. Yeah, I've read this. Message Regina. Well, then when the music stop? Cyberpsycho sure had drive. Had to zero him. Sending you the deets. Shame you couldn't save him. Oh, I did kill him? Poor guy almost completely spiraled out before he even realized what was happening. Guess even pneumatic arms can't lift morale in a toxic workplace. Now it's all out of order. Okay. My. Now that's some creative management. Seems this developer had no problem creating a wide range of business needs and solutions. I'm sure his long-standing connections with weapons dealers, the NCPD, and other shady souls help enormously. And if a certain need isn't great enough, well, there's always the usual solutions of arm twisting and kneecapping. The key to success remains flexibility, especially of the moral sort. Discount dock. The music finally stopped. Send a crew. See, it looks like he's still alive to me. Where's the send a crew thing? One of my workers went cyberpsycho thanks to your exoskeleton. He's out here destroying the whole building. My life's work. Either you send him a quick response crew to dispose of him, or I'll have to call the police. And hey, I wouldn't want the NCPD on my butt asking questions. Neither of us want me to answer. Okay. Don't seem dead to me. Oh, no. Just having some fun. Those aren't explodable. Neither is that. Okay. Yeah, I went in with the bat, too. I hit him too hard, I guess, with it. So now we're going here. Or we could go here. Let's do the reported crime, because I'm not sure if we have enough. These tend to be longer, so I'll make it an even episode with here, with this, and then we'll run back here. It's probably going to take us a while to do whatever's there. It's a high danger, too, so. Let's head here, and then we'll run back next time. Oh, sorry. Came from out of nowhere. Sixth Street Gang. Still alive somehow? But how? Meters that way. An igla? Where's your gun? Over there? Oh, this wasn't even part of it. A light techno polymer helmet. I got a plantain. Well, I don't know if these guys had anything to do with this, but there's also that. Probably not. Maybe they did. I don't see anything else around here. It's getting muddy out here. Scoping out the area first. Meters that way. It was this way, though. Body. But there is something on the other side, at least that's what I said. Despite the body, that's really... Oh my god. Was that a tire that just disintegrated? The sound of the rain on the aluminum, whatever, is really soothing. Or it would be if there wasn't a dead body here. I've had a conversation with Jake. Orders. More street cred. Jake says, got the stash set up. Now all you gotta do is, one, grab the merch, two, give it to the kids, three, collect the eddies from the kids. Oh my god, you're dealing drugs to the kids. Welcome to Night City. Reported crime. Job complete. You do not deal yourself. You do not take any risks. Well, you're giving merchandise and then you're collecting money. You're dealing. The less you're seen and heard, the better. And don't forget, you gotta put up lookouts. Choose which kids are gonna carry the merch, which kids are gonna take the scratch from your clients. Oh. Oh, so they're the middleman, the kids. Easier than you might think. We'll up your stash every Tuesday. Anything goes wrong, call. Stash will be in the garage down on Manzanita. You'll find it all there. Code 1313. Oh. So I want to go follow that then. So then wait. It's done? Welcome to Night City. Our Wraith dealer here chose the wrong market. He made, as they say, a deadly misstep. But now you can get something out of it, right, V? Just check his stash. Oh, it's pretty far, though. Oh, it's all the way over here. Okay, we'll get there eventually. I'm gonna head there first, but not this episode. But it said there was something else this way? Maybe not. I like the outfit. I like the outfit.
Look, I'm waiting for a friend.
You're not waiting anywhere. You're walking away. Die, die, die. Alright, so we're headed this way. Alright, we're gonna take care of this next episode. And then cleared out this area. So after we hit this, we're gonna do this side job here. Collect the stash, the garage on Manzanita Street here, and then go right to the Ripper Dock here. At least that's the plan anyway. Might pick up other things along the way. Who the hell knows? Oh, she's coming back! Hi! Don't honk at her! Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.